Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the series of videos I'm doing about MLOps, and we take again the topic Nvidia AI platform, and we are going to speak today about another component of the depth tools offered by Nvidia with the name of TAO. TAO is the acronym of Train, Adapt and Optimize, and TAO is a toolkit, an SDK that provides Nvidia. It's part of the four main components that Nvidia AI platform offers to work with their cloud service. And essentially, it's a SDK, a toolkit built on top of TensorFlow and PyTorch, which essentially simplified the model training by abstracting the complexity of AI models and the different frameworks. Essentially, as you can see here on this design graph or draft of the architecture, you can see the core is TensorFlow and PyTorch, and offer four main tags with this AutoML. Probably are familiar with this service. Most of the AI cloud providers offer kind of the AutoML capabilities, which essentially you just define the what is the type of problem. Is that supervised, unsupervised problem? It is a regression, classification, time series analysis, computer vision, etc. And then on you provide a data set, and the rest is you propose a target, and the rest is done automatically choosing different algorithms, automatically the SDK, the tool or the application. You have examples very well known in SageMaker of Amazon, Azure Machine Learning Studio, or Vertex AI, even also in Databricks. There is another component to do training and optimization. This is the part we will cover today, and there is as well another part to do labeling, AI assisted annotation of data. This we will cover it as well in another video, and also augmentation. This is leveraged essentially with the library DALI, which we already covered in the channel in a previous video. You can use models either from ONNX model suite, your own models, or but they have to be on ONNX format, and also models from the NVIDIA GPU cloud model repository or model catalog. There is a RESTful API to interact with all these tools that they usually run in Docker. You can choose the infrastructure where you want to run the tool, the TAO components. You can do it in cloud, a VM or a Docker container, running in Amazon, Azure or Google. It's possible to deploy the components also in Google Colab. Today we will cover Google Colab. We can deploy it on premises, or you can deploy it on your personal computer. We will cover soon the requirements to run the minimum requirements to run the TAO toolkit. Also, the train data, you can use data sets. You can prepare the data set with TAO, with the leveraging, depending on the activity, with the library DALI. DALI, if you remember, is a tool to create data sets, kind of similar that you had embedded on the own deep learning libraries, TensorFlow or PyTorch, also, or similar to what we do with Transformers library, create create data sets with data, the manipulate, transform the images, case of that, that we need. Again, this is partially done here or with the help of the DALL-E library. And finally, you can either again choose where to run this. You can run it in infrastructure, cloud, on-premises or local at home, and also you can use calls to the Nvidia A platform where they had an API where they had running infrastructure with everything ready in containers, ready to go. Just you need to invoke a call to the API with the command that you want to do, something similar to, for example, what we have in any of the other ML SaaS services offered by any cloud provider, or the, for example, the API or the Jobs API or Databricks or something similar to that. Finally, the models, we can create, by default, it's going to create, after training and optimization and pruning as well, which is another techniques. You can do training, you can do fine-tuning, you can do evaluation, you can do pruning, which is a kind of optimization, you can do quantization with the tool. And then by the end, once you finish optimizing and tuning your model, you create an ONNX model, and you can do inference in any platform that support the ONNX format, either CPU, CPU, MCO, DLA. If you decide to, you also, it's possible to transform the model or to output the model in format TensorRT, the runtime, the NVIDIA runtime. We also covered this on the channel in a previous video. And then on, if you decide to run it to export it into this format, you will be able only to run it in the NVIDIA infrastructure or inference platform which are compatible with the TensorRT runtime. And obviously only in GPU, because it's the not the limitation, but it's how is the design the TensorRT runtime. So this is what we are gonna see today, TAO, with an example running in, as I said, in a Google Colab. In next videos, we will cover other use cases like running in a workstation, in a local environment, and also in Azure ML service, in Azure Cloud, to review the three main possibilities we have. The requirements to run this on the minimum system configuration is 8 gigabits system run for a GPU, NVIDIA GPU, with 4 gigabits run, 8 cores in a CPU with 8 cores and 100 gigabits of the space. So they recommend a 32 gigabyte CPU. Today we will work with an L4. It's possible to run the example in a T4 as well, and probably most likely even in a local computer with a 4 gigabytes memory, the minimum requirement that you have. You need to run this in Ubuntu, no other choice. You cannot run this in Windows, you cannot run this in Mac. Only Ubuntu, recommended version 22.04, Python higher than 3.9, and the rest, you need to have the CUDA toolkit installed, and the container runtime and some other tools. I later pass you all the requirements in the, I think it's already on the notebook. So, as I said, I had prepared a notebook. I'm running still because the session expired before my previous after running my previous let me check it is working. We will start reviewing the video from the beginning. Save failure, fantastic. Okay, 1 second, and we will go to review the notebook from the beginning. Let me check it is start. Okay, started. Okay, let's start with the notebook. So I just took one of the examples we have on the Nvidia TAO repository. And then here some info. You need to download the TensorRT TAR. You need to log into Nvidia Cloud. You have to have Nvidia Developer account. I have an Nvidia Developer account. I also have an Nvidia Cloud Nvidia GPU Cloud account as well, and in GC there you need to create an API key, sorry. And here in Nvidia Developers you need to get the TensorRT 8.6GA, the version for CUDA 12 and 12.1, the one that is for platforms Linux architecture x86 64 bits. So you need to download this package. This package is 2 gigabytes, and you need to upload it later on to the repository. To Google Colab. So here you have the instructions. Then you need to mount your Google Drive. You can do this as well. You decide to run this in your local computer, you can do it. This is the code is ready for that. So here we are going to do an example multi-class classification. We will use the dataset fashion dataset. This is dataset from Kaggle. You can download as well. I put the link as well on the notebook. This is a dataset with different multiple pictures of clothes, jewelry, shoes, etc. And then there is different classifications. So every picture has different attributes. We will use only some of them to do a model which has three classification targets, which are season, type or category, and article type, color, and season. We will review this now. So you have to download this as well and upload it as well to the Colab notebook. So, let's start. First of all, here you need to download this repository. This repository is gonna be downloaded into the path that you set up here in this environmental variable, Colab notebooks path. Number of GPUs, the key to access to the NGC, NVIDIA GPU Cloud. TAO Docker disable equal one, so this is disabled, not Docker, so we will install this on the box that is running, where is running our Colab Pro. And then on experiment dir, this is has to be something that is in your drive. You had a version, a free version, is not a problem. It's not very big, nor the dataset, neither the runtime. You can, it's more or less 3 gigabytes. So usually the The free version has 30 gigabytes of the disk, so it's more than enough. Unless that you have this full, you can run this notebook. Datadir, this is where you have to upload the file, the dataset file, a repository for the experiments where you are going to put all the logs and models and everything that is producing during the experiments. And here we are just creating directories, which I already had created, so it's not a problem. So here you had the link to download the dataset. We download it. You had to place it in the datadir and then on extract it with ONNX and then on pre-process it. I recommend you to do that because. Sorry, another interruption. Well, once you have the archive.cl, I recommend you to take the style.cv in your local computer and open it with Excel. And as you can see here, there is some extra commas in the column J. We are not going to use it in the training. We are going to use only season, color, and article type. So we will delete it, but it's causing a lot of issues if you don't do that. So I recommend you download this file to your local environment, open it with Excel, remove the column K and L. Just you can keep the J. The rest don't touch it. Save it and upload it again to the same place that you place the rest of the data. Replace the one that you had extracted from the archive.zip because it's gonna cause a lot of issues. Believe me, I spent a lot of time and finally I decided to clean it manually because this command is from a previous version of the pandas. It's not the one you need to update pandas. And finally it's not working really, really well. As the column we are not going to use it, you can check here, we take the ID is the number of the picture, the base color, the subcategory, topware, bottomware, watches, bottom blah blah blah, season, fall, summer, winter, fall, etc. So we don't use that column, so it's no harm in to delete these two columns, additional columns, and you will avoid to spend a lot of time trying to load the file and avoid the. Again, it's up to you if you want to follow my recommendation. But well, I spent almost 1 hour trying to clean it, and finally I decided to do this because I realized that there is no point to try to correct that column, which essentially we don't use. Here we just rename the header, and we process the images only for the columns only for the rows that are valid. So we have 10 classes for category, 4 seasons and 11 colors. Then we only choose the images that are included on the final dataset and the final data frame. I think that with the correction I did, we use all of them. And here, just essentially, we divide or we split the data frame in train and validation. I don't like too much how they did that. We could use perfectly train test split from scikit-learn because we can use. In the split the segmentation or the stratification, sorry, using the columns we had, the categories, but well, they decide to do it like this. This is just this I copy from the original notebook, but you can do a better split just using stratification and the train test split. So in any case, it's not going to change too much. It's just an example of how we can use the TAO toolkit. We do some counting, 28,000 rows for training, and then from this training, the TAO toolkit during the training is taking 20% of this trained dataset for validation during training, and this is used to evaluate the performance of the model. This is the holdout dataset 3137. We just plot what we have here. Now we download the Nvidia GPU Cloud CLI just to download the model. We are going to download a pre-trained model. So something I forgot to say before is here in the overview. So we have here more than 100 pre-trained vision AI models, not only vision, also we have LLMs for different purposes. You can choose here all the tags that we have, the different models that we have, etc. Semantic segmentation, we are gonna do classification, and we have So we had post classification. So the activity we are gonna do is image classification. I'm gonna use ResNet. So you have all these models are pre-trained on the model catalog of the NVIDIA GPU cloud. So here you have all the information. It's really interesting and really useful to read at least what is the main features of the toolkit. Really impressive what these people do. And as I will comment at the end, if you have no budget problems and you can run inference training everything in GPUs. The best alternative is obviously to use the NVIDIA AI platform and use the tools because they are optimized to run in NVIDIA GPUs and they have no competitor. So, okay, here we just install the library in the CLI from NVIDIA GPU Cloud. You can, once it's installed, you can execute it in command line. You have different commands as commands. Here we are going to just list what we have on the model repository for classification. This is the pre-trained model that we had there. So there is some of them. We can upgrade here. Yeah, we had a version a little bit old, but yeah, it's not a big problem. So if you just simply NVIDIA TAO pre-trained classification, so this means that you can just changing here for one of these other groups, you can check which pre-trained model you have. Here we create a subdirectory, a folder to download the model, and here you have the command to download the model, the ResNet 10, to the folder experiment. And if you can check here, the model is a Keras model, Keras pre-trained model that they already had available on their directory. Now we are going to set up the TensorRT framework or runtime, sorry. This is the TAR that you download from here. And then you have to place it in a directory. You put the path here, And then on you create also a path to unfolder the tar, and also you had to place the version. In this case is 8.6.1.6. So once you had created all the paths and the set up all the library paths, we start to install the runtime. We are installing the runtime in the Google Colab box, in the in the operating system. You can check here. We are installing here. This is already there. Yeah, this is a Linux 64. It's the box, that personalize Google to run the Colab notebox. This take a while, 47 minutes. So take a coffee after it's done. Let me hide output. And now here we just going to take from the repository that you download here in this command. So here you need to put the key. I don't know if I mentioned before the key of the Nvidia GPU cloud, and here the repository. I commented this because I did that manually. I don't know what happened but this command didn't work very well. So essentially I just create the folder repos and I clone it manually using the terminal, because it was easy to do it that way. So once you had that, from the directory, this is on results, exactly, pre-trained, ResNet, no, sorry, it's in repos, Nvidia TAO, you have PyTorch, TensorFlow, and then you can go to EfficientNet, sorry, ResNet. Where is that? Multitask classification, sorry. Go to specifications, and here you had a template to do the classification and to do the reclassification, the retraining after pruning. So the classification is simply a dictionary, a JSON file with all the parameters. The architecture, if you want to use batch normalization, etc. This is how they set up, and then on you add here your paths. This is automatically done with these commands, and then here we are just replacing in the file, in the template, where we had the model, where we had the train and validation dataset, and where we had the images directory. What more, TAO, once you have installed it, you have access to TAO. TAO is also working via command line. You have three main task groups. Dataset is to create datasets, deploy to deploy into an inference server. Triton is the one that we will see in the next video. Is the inference server provided by NVIDIA. We will see together with the TensorRT. Well, TensorRT, we already had a tutorial in the channel. A model is the tags which we will use today. You can check here. If you use TAO model, you can use different options. Multitask classification is the one that we are going to use today. And there is a lot there you can use now. This is still running, and if we simply execute this here, you can check. It's still not We're still not finishing. Let me check where we are. Still we are in the epoch 6. So here you check the model categories. Zero season accuracy, base color accuracy. Well, I will stop here after it's finished and then on we will continue with the video. Okay, the training, the initial training finish. Here you get the number, so the help of multitask classification is the one that we are doing here. So essentially we use train, multitask classification. You can do train, prune, inference, explore, evaluate, conf-mat. This is prune. This is essentially remove the part of the weights that are not making any impact on the performance of the model. Inference, obviously, to do inference, export to ONNX, and evaluate is just to use the train dataset to evaluate the model. Confusion matrix is just to print out in this classification algorithm how it's performing versus the different targets. As you can see here, the model we are we use TAO model multi-class classification train. We use the specification file that we saw before, experimented there to just output all the checkpoints, the key to access the NGC and the number of GPUs that in this case is one. As you can see here, this is a Keras model. We had three linear layers at the end of the ResNet architecture. It's a ResNet with 10 hidden layers, and here we had three targets. One is color with 11 categories, category with 10 categories, redundancy, sorry, and season with 4 categories. This training the model, and here we had the output. Pretty simple. You just need to set up your data set. You just need to create the metadata for training and invoke the training. You don't need to set up additional libraries. Everything is included on the TAO Toolkit, and as you can see, very simple to train this architecture, which is not simple. It's an architecture quite complex, no? With three targets, three linear layers at the head of the neural network, and well, here at the end of the process, here we had a is saving, as you can see, every epoch is saving a checkpoint, and then on what we can do is choose. I create here some logic to open the CSV, and you can choose now the one that is performing better. So here we have season accuracy, here the later epochs is the better one, validation accuracy 98.59, also the best, and here the best is this one, but yeah, this one is not bad as well in terms of the 98.5, this 98.6, and here is 73. Yeah, this is a little bit worse. Yeah, well, you can choose surely if we extend the number of epochs, will be better. Now we just take the epoch 10, we assign it to this variable, and then on we simply evaluate with the same toolkit, TAO model multitask evaluate the experiment here. It's just here the checkpoint that we are gonna use, the specification file. Here, from here we are going to take the validation dataset and the key to access NGC. So here we just initialize. So here we are working with TensorFlow Keras. I will stop just to, and when it's finished, we will continue. But here, printing the again. I think this is quite fast. Yeah, here is fast. So we have here the parameters 77, 78. Yeah, later we will compare. Now we are gonna prune the model. Prune the model. So now we will prune the model. Pruning the model is just removing those. I will say, yeah, weights that they are not doing an impact on the performance on the model. There is, as you can read the documentation, there is always a trade-off in between pruning more or less, because if you prune more, your model is smaller, getting a smaller model is better for you increase the efficiency. You need a smaller GPU probably, but if you prune a lot the model, you have an impact at the end on the performance. And then what we are gonna do here is just you need to set as a threshold. The threshold is everything that is impacting is impacting with every weight that is impacting below this threshold is gonna be removed. If you increase this threshold, you will remove more. If you decrease this, you will remove less. What means remove? Yes, you will remove less weights from the model, or more weights from the model. You will make the model smaller or more smaller, depending on this threshold, which means the deleting or removing more or less weights from the trained model that we just trained. So the command is pretty simple as well. We just execute prune with the same command: model multiclass classification prune experiment. This is the model that we are gonna prune. This is the output. This is how we are gonna do it: the equal union. Then on the threshold, the key for NGC, and then on the results to experiment logs. Let's do it. It's gonna take some minutes as well. I stop here. Okay, it's done. Now we just print the model. If you check here, it's practically 12 megabits. Let's check how big is the other model. Let me check. Let's check how big was this model. You can see here we essentially reduce the model from 55 megabytes to 12 megabytes. So essentially, yeah, practically you say here 0.65, we reduce 65% of the model we remove it from the original one. Now we are gonna retrain the model. We use the same the other configuration. This is provided by Nvidia, multi-class classification retrain specification. So we have the same model config, the batch size, epochs, etc., the learning rate, regularizer, optimizer, and then where we have the prune model, etc. Now we train. This is exactly the same that before, but now instead to take the pre-trained model downloaded from the NGC model repository, take our pruned model, and it's gonna do another training with 10 epochs. So I will stop again, and then when it's done, I will continue. Okay, the training is done with the pruned model. Now we are gonna do the same exercise. We will take the evaluation. So here again, season, this is the last, and here last, yeah, here the number 10 as well. So we are gonna take the 10 one, yeah, exactly the 10. We do the evaluation. And then on now here we will compare with the what we got in the previous evaluation using the model. So as you can see here, there is a degradation on the performance. Obviously we removed 65% of the model, but still before was 77, now it's 75, 98.72, 98.34, and 75.52, 73.19. So you can, as I mentioned, you can choose, this is a trade-off between the accuracy and performance and size of the model, no? We reduce 65% the size of the model, and we lose a little bit of accuracy. Here, obviously, the model is also, in this case, we are using not many epochs, probably not sure. With the amount of images that we have, is probably, if we increase this to 20, 30 epochs, we will get better outcomes, especially on the two categories where is all the two classifiers with our performing worse. And then we can keep this pruning, this percentage of pruning before, or simply don't prune a lot, or just prune less percentage of the model. You can do different tests on your own. Yes. Now we are going to do the confusion matrix. And now here you had, it's not, especially if you have a lot of classes like in our case, it's pretty clear that there is misclassified points. So this is the color. Obviously category was the best classifier, not many, but still some of them. And the type, the category type, there is also, in the season, there is a lot of the misclassified points as well. Again, we can improve the performance, extending the dataset or extending as well the number of epochs. Now we are gonna do inference. Here we have azure, color white, it's clear. The quality of the image is not very good, but well, it is like it is. Color white, since that is a exported sparse su. It's done, no wrong. Now we are going to do inference as well with the, you see we didn't change the toolkit. Pretty simple to use once you have the, everything configured. You can do experiments very quickly, very easy, and the inference as well. So here we are using the, yeah, here you load the model, we prune it, and here we had category Y, SUS, summer. Yeah, exactly. I don't know if there is a categories of sporty SUS, it's simply SUS. And the color is correct, and summer, well, it's, you have to classify something with color white, I will say summer as well. Okay, that's pretty much all. Really, really interesting technology, as I said if, at the beginning. If your plan is to work with the acceleration, you know very well that there is no competitor for NVIDIA. So the best is to use their tools. They are optimized. All these tools are developed under the hood in C++. They don't have interfaces with Python, with other languages as well. And they are using, they're exporting everything to a ONNX, so meaning that we can use multiple inference services. So it's really quite complex, not complex, it's quite complete, exactly, complete. The toolkit, we can do practically everything, and then I'm using NVIDIA infrastructure, which means to use essentially GPU. Everything is in this toolkit, and the tools that we are seeing are optimized to run in GPU, in NVIDIA GPUs. And obviously, at least the toolkit developed by them, they know very well how their technology works. It is done, as I said, everything under the hood on C++, then on bindings with Python, and it's extremely fast. You can take a look to the video I recorded 3 or 4 weeks ago about TensorRT, how quickly is in comparison with other, how fast is the runtime in GPU, no, in comparison with the inference using the PyTorch conventional inference, for example, is 3 times faster using the runtime. So if you have no budget problems and your plan is to run and to do training and everything in a accelerated environment, the choose the selection of the environment is pretty clear. So you had always the provider which is a leader on the market, which is NVIDIA. So no discussion that they had the better technology in terms of acceleration today. We'll see in a point on the future, but today, in my opinion, it's only my opinion, there is no competitor to do what they are doing. No, probably in the future, well, with quantum technologies, or Intel is doing a lot of stuff as well to run in models in the Intel GPUs, open by node from Intel as well. Well, there is a lot of going on, but still, in my opinion, what NVIDIA have is really difficult to beat. They have a lot of things done, and the other competitors, in my opinion, are a little bit behind them. No? But yeah, we'll see the picture in some time, because also you know that this is changing very quickly, very fast. So what we say today probably is not valid in 1 week. So in this world today, this is extremely, everything happening extremely fast. New models, new techniques, new hardware, everything smaller, faster. And yeah, it's not only improving the hardware, improving the software, improving the architectures, improving everything. So yeah, it's a very dynamic, very, very extremely dynamic world. And we need to know many details to later on do the best choice to the problem that we are working on. Again, in my opinion, if you plan to, you have no budget issues and you can do inference in GPUs and depending as well the complexity of the problems, Nvidia has no competitors. If you plan to run something in cheap hardware, go for OpenBINO of Intel, because well, they had also they had done a very good job in that matter, and yeah, for now we will continue with other use cases. Today we run the toolkit in a Google notebook, a Google Colab notebook. My plan is to run this as well in Docker containers. I had the containers already down. You can simply download the containers. Is everything set up. The only thing that you need to do is invocate the same commands that we use here, with invocate them in using the Docker run. So we call TAO. We had to mount some persistent volumes to the Docker to load the data, to have access the data, to have access to push the models, to create to log all the experiments, etc. But the easiest way is to use this. You can deploy these Dockers to Kubernetes, to a VM in any cloud provider, to one server in your premises, and finally you interact with the Docker. And the same that we did here, command line installing, you can do the same exactly this, instead to run it, for example, this command here in local, we can add to a Docker run and execute the same. So we need to do as well like the same that we did here, with some creating some environmental variables, etc. We can do exactly the same in a Docker, and yeah, you just pull the Docker and ready to go. Here the same version, I think we can do here version, if I'm not wrong. Let me check it. We can do TAO version. TAO-guion version. I'm not really sure, but I think. Nice. It's not here. Maybe. Ah, well, exactly. No, but what we use is the Tensor runtime. It's the version we have here. Okay, so not a problem. I will check how we can verify which version we are using. But in my opinion, we are using the same, because I download yesterday I download the these Dockers are the latest version, so probably we are using is the same version that they had on their premises. Okay, that's pretty much all. Thank you very much for watching the video to this point. I hope that it was useful for your training, for your job, for whatever reason are you watching these videos. And if so, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and yeah, make comments if you find something, you struggle to do something, or you find that is something is not working on your environment, I will try to help, and just share with your friends and colleagues just to help me to grow in YouTube. I will upload this now to the repo, and I will put on the comments of the video how you can access to this in your, and be able later to run it in your local environment or in your account in Colab. You don't need to use Colab Pro. I'm using Colab Pro with IL4, but you can use perfectly the free version of Colab. Okay, thank you very much and see you soon.